last week, Auntie Anita talked to you about the treasure in the field. Do you remember that? What's the treasure? Or if Jesus is the man looking for the treasure, what is the treasure? The field is the earth, and the treasure is so. I want to. You are the treasure. You are the treasure Jesus is seeking, and He sold everything to pay for you. Okay, let's start with prayer. Lord, we ask that You would just bless this time together today, Lord. That You would bless our meeting, and Lord, that You would give us a word to take with us as we go. In Jesus' name, amen. All right. The lesson today is taken off on that because the scripture also tells us that we have this treasure hidden. Once He has found us, He's come to the field, He's dug us up, He's found us. We've been rescued out of the miry clay. And you know, God made us out of what? What did God make man out of? The dust of the earth. What happens when you mix dust with water? Clay. That's why I brought the clay. It's Play-Doh. It's not really truly earthen clay. But did any of you notice that the clay was a little bit hard when you started to squish it and then it got a little bit softer? Yeah, God works with us that way. Sometimes it's hard and we resist and we don't want to be molded. But the Bible tells us that He molds us and makes us. He's our maker. In 2 Corinthians 4:7, it tells us that we have this treasure in earthen vessels. Wait a minute, let's back up and see what treasure that is. It said, it is God who commanded light to shine out of darkness, who has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels, the excellence of the power may be of God and not of us. So, in your heart, and one of my favorite Bible verses is Psalm 119:11, and I remember it, 11911. 911, it's an emergency. Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. And remember that I am a beloved child of God. I need to accept His sacrifice for my sin. Is there anybody here who's not a sinner? Anybody here who's never sinned? I think there was only one, yes. I think there was only one, and that was Jesus, the Son of God. And He managed to live a sinless life to sacrifice His own life to buy us. And we hide Him in our hearts. We hide the Word of God in our hearts. We hide He is known as the Word. He says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So as we submit ourselves to Him, as we recognize Him, as we accept His sacrifice, as we ask for His forgiveness and are willing to repent, turn around from our sins, He makes us new, and He makes us better, softer. He works us, and He makes us softer and shapes us in the shape that He wants us to be as we submit ourselves to Him. So I want you to remember that He is the Word of God. And that word, that treasure, has been hidden in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. And the glory is God's, not ours. It's all God. So I want to thank you. You can keep the clay. You can share it. And I'm going to say a prayer. Father, we thank You for bringing us together. Thank You for making us out of the clay of the earth. Thank You for giving hearts that are softened by Your hand, that You soften our hearts to receive Jesus and to share Jesus and to hide Your word, the word of God, our Lord Jesus Christ, in our hearts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.